Okay, true love. Dessert is coming up.
Oh, yeah.
We're going into dessert, and that's a little hint, true love. Oh, Nelly. Oh, Nelly. Here we go, diving right in into the studio. Hope you're doing well, and thank you all for chiming into yesterday where I kind of went on a little rant about listening to, like, I just want to make sure we clear the air that on the Houston Marathon yesterday, and we're really going to clear the air on the Houston Marathon right now, in or out, out or in. I'll get you the answer here in a second. But yesterday I was just talking about how I have to listen to my own training philosophy and listen to, obviously, to my own body. Remember the question of the day yesterday was, do you feel like you have a grasp on your own personal pain scale? Like, how much can your body handle? How much mentally can you handle when you're dealing with a niggle, an ache, a pain, maybe even like a lack of sleep, which can then impact our mental state? So there's a lot that goes into that personal pain scale. And I think I do have a pretty good grasp on my own pain scale and on my own personal talent level. So I'm not a high school kid that was recruited. I wasn't recruited out of high school to go run in college. I had to walk on to the University of Colorado cross country and track team my sophomore year of college. Because in high school, like, I was decent, but I wasn't near the top in state cross country or state track. I had to fight for it. And I feel like in high school, I did it. For those that have been watching, you've heard me share this story before. Like, I feel like my talent was there, but it wasn't fully extracted or pulled out of me in high school. And it was inside me to believe, like, I think there's more there to give. And I'm now applying those lessons of high school into college, into this attempt to run an Olympic trials qualifying time of 2:19, which is why yesterday I ran 21 miles, because I know that for my talent level, my fitness needs to be at a certain level in order to reach that 2:19, because I can't just snap my fingers like Bernard Lagat, a 45-year-old, and go crank out, what did he run this year, a 2:12 something? There it is on your screen right now. So he's going to be in Atlanta running the Olympic trials for the marathon, which is amazing as a 45-year-old, but I can't just snap my finger like that. So that's one first reason I ran 21 miles yesterday at 6:30 a mile. But the second reason is I was seeking an answer to the question, Houston, in or out? Out or in? Because I knew 21 miles would basically tell me the knee is going to hold up or the knee is not going to hold up, okay? So I did the 21 miles, 3 miles where the pain was 3 or 4, 18 miles essentially pain-free. Pretty exciting stuff, right? But I also knew I needed to go to bed last night and then wake up today and see how it felt. And so the answer to the question, in or out, is very clear, all right? Again, the pain scale and knowing what it's going to take to not only maintain my fitness, which is pretty high right now, but also to sharpen a little bit, okay? I need, you know, sharpen a little bit where I can, you know, go get that turnover going. So my decision, and I appreciate everyone's opinions and thoughts and support and cheering me on all over the place, but I'm out. I'm out of the Houston Marathon. I'm out of the Olympic trials. It's a hard decision. It's a lifelong dream to race the Olympics. The Olympics, meaning i.e. my personal Olympics, the Olympic trials. I cannot, it's not gonna work. It's just, it's not, it's the knee is saying no, 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 no. It's too much. I don't think it would be long-term damage to the knee if I push through. In fact, I'll just say a little anecdote. If I was getting ready for the Olympics in Tokyo, if I had made the Olympic marathon team, I would push through. You know, that is a whole nother discussion. I'm trying to qualify for the Olympic trials, which, frankly, I'll just say right now, I think there's going to be more opportunities down the road. Paris 2024, I'm already thinking long-term. So I don't think it would be long-term damage, but I know, remember what I said, like, I'm not going to Houston to run 2 hours and 30 minutes. It's not, it just doesn't make, it's not logical. And I'll also add, 2020 is going to be so much more enjoyable, so much sweeter, if I can rest up now, get completely healthy now, and then come back stronger, and I have, oh man, I have a thought I was thinking about inside, but come back stronger for one spring marathon and one fall marathon. So this is how you race marathons. This year, obviously Amsterdam was my first attempt at the OTQ, and then I did New York for my mom, but traditionally, what you need to do as a marathon runner is one in the spring and one in the fall, okay? That's the smart way to race marathons. So that's now on the table. Like that's part, instead of let's say running Houston, and even let's say I ran 2:18:30, then I would run another marathon 5 or 6 weeks later, about 5 weeks later in Atlanta, which would be so exciting, a lifelong dream, but by not pushing through this pain, it allows a lot of doors to open for 2020. And one last point that I thought about inside is chasing fitness versus embracing fitness. A little tip of the day, when you're chasing fitness, you're rushing the training block, right? Rather than embracing the fitness where you're taking that patience approach and the fitness that is building up inside of you through patience and not rushing the volume buildup, not rushing the intensity of the workouts. It's more of a natural way where your body is adapting to what you're putting it through in the training, rather than, okay, overreaching. Like if you follow me on Strava, you can sense like the last 8 weeks, it was all a little rushed, and I knew it would be, and I wasn't afraid of it. But at the end of the day, the body gets the last word, and the body is saying, no more. Whereas, look into the future, I'm not afraid to say, like Paris 2024, I believe the window opens up, I think it's a three-year window that marathon runners have for USA track and field athletes to qualify for the Olympic trials. So again, that's obviously down the road. It's gonna be fun to chase it again down the road. And not do it in an overreaching manner, okay? Overreaching manner. And now I have the experience of Amsterdam, of New York, and of future marathons this spring, and then New York City next fall once again, where I can just continue to dial in the marathon training and racing experience. All right, so cool. All right, we are, True Love and I, we're off to date night. Let's go tell True Love together. Let's just go tell True Love. We've been contemplating and talking and discerning together, like, what's this knee injury look like and how are we gonna work through this together? So come on now, let's go, go let her know. Go, Dana. There she is. Friday night, oh my God. We never go out on Friday nights. Here we go. Oh my, hun. Here we go, it's cold. I'm not saying my car is warmed up. Cochino taco, cochino taco.
Otherwise known as liquid
gold. To the break, to the break. Cheers. True Love does not know the Houston Marathon update yet. We'll get that to you in a minute. It's a little loud in the restaurant, so we might do that at the dessert place.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
How's that sound? How's that sound? True Love, she didn't like her dinner at all.
It was so awful. Just the taste, the flavors were just not there.
No dice. Okay, True Love. Dessert is coming up.
Oh, yeah.
We're going into dessert, and that's a little hint, True Love, as to my decision for the Houston Marathon. Yes, we're gonna call it. We're calling it.
Okay.
Because of the knee, everybody, you know the story.
Yeah.
It just, and even sitting in the restaurant just now,
yeah,
it's killing, it's hurting. 21 miles yesterday. It just hurts.
Ouch.
So
ouch.
We're gonna give it a rest.
Listen, I understand.
Gonna give it a rest.
Yeah, we gotta give it a rest.
And 2020 will be that much sweeter by taking a rest now. You know what I mean?
No, that's true. That's good perspective.
You know, it just...
And Dave, you're just getting started. You're going to qualify for the next two Olympics, I say.
Olympic trials.
I meant...
You know.
Well?
Same thing. Well, watch out. Hey, Paris, we will see you.
Wow.
So anyway, we're calling it.
That's a hard decision.
It's a hard decision, but it's the right decision because the pain scale that we've been talking about, you just got to know your body and listen to it.
That's it. That's all you have to do. You're listening. You're tuned in.
Yeah.
You're honed in. And you know what? We did everything. We really gave it our best shot.
Physical therapy.
Yeah. The massages.
Massage therapy.
Yeah. Heating.
Rest.
Yeah.
For 4 days.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day.
Yeah. It's not meant to be.
Not meant to be this time.
And you know what?
This time. We're going to keep fighting. But it's just going to be a longer fight than we anticipated.
Yeah.
So thank you for sticking with us through Amsterdam, New York, and even well before that.
Yeah.
So.
In a sense, we are babies. We are just getting started.
Yeah.
With all of this. I'm proud of you, hon. That's
marathon business.
Yeah.
All right. We're going to toss it back, everyone, to, I think when the knee injury kind of first arrived on the right, just to give you the full perspective of what we've been through. And then on the left, we'll toss it back to, what should we toss it back to?
Oh, gosh.
Amsterdam.
Where it all started.
Amsterdam. Yeah. All right, everyone. Seek beauty.
Work hard.
And love each other.
We'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
We love you.